Time now for an update from Fox Carolina News and Fox Carolina Weather. Weather rates certified most accurate.
Good afternoon. We'll check in with Chief Meteorologist Kendra Kent in just a moment to see how your weekend is shaping up and possibility of a wet start to your Monday. We'll see her in just a moment, but let's head to foxcarolina.com right now. Our top story, an attempted murder suspect is locked up after a road rage incident on I-85 northbound near Malden Road on Thursday morning. We were in bond court last night as the suspect faced a judge. His bond was denied. He's been identified as Troy Wheeler. What we learned from the Greenville County Sheriff's Office is that three 17-year-olds were in a car and apparently they brake checked this individual. And that's when the Sheriff's Office says at some point during this whole range of events that happened after the brake check that Troy Wheeler shot into the teen's car yesterday morning around 11:30. Fortunately, no one was hit. We're told that the Greenville County Sheriff's Office put out a BOLO for Mr. Wheeler's car. It was found in Spartanburg County a short time later and he was arrested. He was brought back to Greenville County yesterday and now facing three counts of attempted murder. In bond court, he did address the judge saying he did not deny what happened. He said, "I felt like I was having a flashback of being back in Iraq because I feel like I was being attacked by another vehicle." He went on to say, "I was not in the right frame of mind at the time. I'm very apologetic, but I was not in the right frame of mind." He went on to say, "I am a combat veteran, Purple Heart veteran. I just want to apologize for what happened." And we'll have much more on this coming up at 4, 5, and 6, and tonight at 10 and 11. DHEC putting out new numbers this afternoon. 3,528 new cases confirmed today with more than 20 confirmed deaths as of this afternoon, bringing the statewide total since the pandemic began to 369,782 cases. Greenville County leading the state with total new daily cases, followed by Spartanburg County. Can break those all down right here inside the article. And we're also following up on a couple other stories, including charges filed in a Sunday shooting over in Cherokee County. Now, the suspect is actually the woman who was shot, and we're told that the shooter will not be charged in that. Apparently, it was a self-defense case. However, the woman, who we're told had a butcher knife, is being charged with attempted murder. She was released from the hospital and charged on Wednesday. And check this out, folks. $1 billion up for grabs tonight in the Mega Millions drawing at 11 p.m. right here on Fox Carolina. Nobody has hit this jackpot since September. Of course, earlier this week, the Powerball jackpot was hit, $730 million. It went to a couple in a small town in Maryland. I believe 1,200 people are in that little town. The couple lived there for many years, so they became multimillionaires. Well, someone tonight could become a multimillionaire as well, because by the time you get taxes out, you're still going to take home, folks, more than $500 million if you take the cash option. You have till 10 p.m. to buy your tickets, cash only, and then that billion-dollar drawing at 11 o'clock right here on Fox Carolina. Let's bring in Chief Meteorologist Kendra Kenton. Kendra, we've seen this happen over in Simpsonville. Mm-hmm. $1.5 billion jackpot was hit there at the KC Mart. So it could happen.
Cody,
we'll
see. You got to remember to go buy
tonight,
tickets.
Tonight, I'm buying one.
Yes,
I have to. Yeah. I don't know why. I mean, I should play when it's $10 million, but.
Well, exactly. That's life-changing, too, but a billion. You could go buy an island.
Know.
Goodness gracious.
I will not be here on Monday, Kendra. No, I always say I'll come back to work, but if I win a billion, I'm not.
I know. I tell her it's nothing personal, but I need a little time. Well, let's look at tonight's forecast as we're going to be down into the low 30s. It's going to be a colder night than we've had the last couple. 33, mostly clear for the upstate, so you'll have to bundle up for an early Saturday morning activity. 26 in the mountains, so colder than it has been. And then looking ahead to tomorrow, classic January weather, a sunny sky and highs near normal at 55 in the upstate, 48. For Western North Carolina. Of course, you'll want to check in on the 4, 5, and 6 o'clock newscast this evening and on the 10 and 11 o'clock news, and download the Fox Carolina app.